Hello friends, my name is Viren Singh. In this video tutorial, I am going to discuss about the continuous operations and various mechanisms in continuous operations. Let's discuss the introduction about the continuous operation. As I told you in previous videos, that is, in continuous operation, there is continuous input and output supply is there. Continuous culture can be divided into chemostat and turbidostat. In chemostat, the chemical composition concentration kept constant by limiting the concentration of limiting nutrient. In turbidostat, the turbidity or cell number kept constant by varying the flow rate. Continuous culture can be divided into tank culture and plug flow reactor. It operates at steady state. Steady state means dx by dt, that is biomass concentration with respect to time, change in substrate concentration with respect to time, and change in product concentration with respect to time is zero. Let's discuss the biomass production in the chemostat. As I told you, in chemostat, there is continuous input feeding and continuous removal of the product or biomass. That means Mi is Fx, Mi is equal to F into X0, that is initial cell concentration, and M0 equal to F into X, that is final concentration. Volume is constant here because the flow input flow rate is equal to output flow rate. As I discussed in previous videos, remember those steps and use those steps here as I discussed in fed batch culture and batch culture also. First, calculate the various parameters Mi equal to F into X0, Mo equal to F into X, rate of generation is mu into X into V, rate of consumption Kd into X into V minus Kd into X into V. If Kd equal to 0, then Rc equal to 0. The second step is use mass balance equation and put the values here in this equation, and you will get this equation Fx0 minus Fx plus mu xV equal to V dx by dt. Here volume is constant, then it comes out from the differential parameters. The third step is divide the whole equation by volume V. You will get this equation dilution rate dx0 minus dx plus mu x equal to dx by dt. At steady state, dx by dt is equal to 0. And if sterile feed is used at input, then x0 is equal to 0. And you will get mu minus dx equal to 0. X cannot be 0 because in between the process, the biomass concentration cannot be 0. There is some cell in the reactor, so X cannot be 0. That's why mu minus D equal to 0, and that means mu equal to D. What is the value of D? Mu M S Ks plus S. And what is the value of D? Flow rate upon volume. So this is the biomass production in the chemostat. Let's discuss the substrate utilization in chemostat. In chemostat, there is continuous feeding of substrate and continuous removal. That means Mi equal to Fs0, initial substrate concentration, and Mo is equal to F into S. Here, flow rate is same for the input feed stream and output feed stream. Volume is constant here because the flow rate is equal. Calculate the various parameter Mi, Mo, Rg, Rc, Qsv, and what is the value of Qs? As I told you in previous videos, this is for the biomass production, this parameter for the product formation, and this parameter for the maintenance coefficient. Use the material balance equation and put the value of various parameter, and you will get this equation. Volume is constant, that's why V comes out from the differential coefficient. Divide the whole equation by volume, you will get this equation. Flow rate converted into dilution rate, and at steady state ds by dt equal to 0, then you will get this equation. Put the complete expression of Qs in the equation 2 and you will get equation number 3. In equation 3, if there is no product formation is occurs, that means Qp is 0, and there is no maintenance, then Ms is 0, and at steady state mu equal to D. As I mentioned you in the biomass production, then you will get this equation S0 equal to X by X. this is the yield equation. You will get yield equation and put the value of S. What is the value of S? From the monod equation, you will get this equation. From the monod equation, put the value of S here and you will get this equation. X equal to Y axis S naught minus Ks into D divided by mu m minus D. For X maximum, S final must be the 0. Put the value here and you will get the X maximum equation for the chemostat. If KD is not 0, if the death coefficient is not 0 as I assumed in various mechanism, in various processes, then equation number 3 is like this. D S naught minus S D plus KD X upon Y axis M. Or you can say, if you manipulate this equation, send the X here and you will get this equation. E here, S naught minus S upon X is 1 upon XS AP, that is apparent yield. And here it is maximum yield. And you can see, manipulate this equation and you will get this equation 1 upon YXS AP equal to 1 upon YXS M plus MS upon KD. Here MS equal to KD upon YXS M. You can see this is the straight line graph. If you plot the curve between 1 upon XS AP, that is apparent yield, 1 upon apparent yield and 1 upon dilution rate, you will get straight line with the intercept 1 upon maximum yield and slope maintenance coefficient. This is very important equation. Please remember this equation. This will help you to calculate various numericals related to the bioprocess engineering for the chemostat operations. Let's discuss product formation in chemostat. In chemostat, there is continuous input and continuous output is there. That means Mi is equal to Fp0. Here is initial product concentration. And Mo is equal to F into P. P is final concentration. And volume is constant here. Calculate various parameters Mi, Mo, Rg, Rc and M. This is the first step to calculate the material balance in product formation. Rg is equal to Qp into X into V, where Qp is specific product formation rate, X is the biomass concentration. Second step is use the material balance equation and put the values and you will get this equation Fp0 minus Fp plus Qp into X into V equal to V into dP by dt. Here V is constant, that's why it comes out from the differential coefficient. Divide the whole equation by V and you will get this equation. At steady state, dP by dt is equal to 0 and you will get this equation, that is dP minus P0 equal to Qp into X, or you can say P equal to P0 plus Qp into X. This equation represents the product concentration in chemostat. There is very important condition in chemostat, that is washout condition. Washout condition means cells in the reactor is completely washout from the reactor. That means there is no cells present in the reactor. X equal to 0 or tends to 0. This condition comes when dilution rate tends to mu maximum. And when dilution rate tends to mu maximum and X tends to 0, then this condition is known as washout condition. And at washout condition, S is steady state substrate concentration is tends to maximum substrate concentration, that is S0. In the washout condition, rate of cell removal is greater than the rate of cell generation. Obviously, if this rate of cell removal is greater than the rate of cell generation, that completely the cell is comes out from the reactor. The flow rate is very high. Here you can easily say dilution rate is directly proportional to the flow rate upon volume. So flow rate very high, that's why D is very high and it tends to mu maximum. What is D critical? Critical dilution rate, the dilution rate at which washout condition occurs, known as D critical. The D formula of D critical is mu max into S naught Ks plus S naught. Remember the formula of D critical, and you can see X versus dilution rate and S versus dilution rate graph. Here x tends to 0 and s tends to maximum at d critical. Here this is the d critical. Let's discuss the another important condition in the chemostat, that is d optimal condition or optimum dilution rate. As you know, the biomass productivity, that is qx, equal to mu into x or dx at steady state. And what is the value of x from the yield value? That is s naught minus s into yxs. And put the value of s here from the monod kinetics, ks d into d mu m minus d, and we will get this equation. When to differentiate this equation qx with respect to the dilution rate, you will get the optimum dilution rate. The dilution rate at which the rate of biomass production reaches to the maximum, known as optimal dilution rate. If you differentiate qx value with respect to dilution rate and equate the value is equal to 0, you will get d optimal. After differentiating with this equation with respect to dilution rate and equating equal to 0, you will get the formula of d optimal, that is nu max 1 minus under root ks upon ks plus s naught. And d optimal must be less than the d critical. You can see this is the biomass productivity and this is the dilution rate. If you plot the graph between dilution rate and biomass productivity, it will look like this. And this is the maximum productivity and this is the d optimal. And when the productivity tends to 0, this is the d critical. You can see from graph also, d optimum is less than the d critical. These are the some advantages and disadvantages of continuous culture. That is, this is more productivity, optimal environment conditions. Significantly, it is more productivity in terms of fermentation downtime per unit of product manufactured than batch or fed batch. Lower operating cost. But the disadvantages is that higher initial capital expenditure and relatively few large scale industrial examples of the chemostat or CSTRs. So this is all about the chemostat and the biomass production, substrate utilization and product formation in chemostat, and the washout condition and optimal condition in the chemostat. Remember all the formulas which helps you to solve the numericals related to this concept. Thank you for watching my video. If you like my video, please do like and subscribe my channel for more updates. Thank you.